ground and recharge the water table. Test bore wells that have been sunk at different locations on the site will continue to record salinity levels of the groundwater. The culverts at Santom Causeway will be cleaned and eventually enlarged to allow an increased flow of tidal water into the creek. Surrounding communities have dumped municipal solid waste into the creek. This has created a menace of rodents and mosquitoes, leading to health hazards and degradation of existing water quality. A solid waste management program is proposed, along with a resident-led advanced locality management program. Overall, a dynamic and interactive landscape of forests, wetlands, mudflats, and ponds will be created. On the drier edges of the creek, indigenous species of the tropical dry evergreen forest will be introduced. A phased control of the invasive Prosopis velikattan will be carried out, as the trees are currently used by the herons for nesting. The natural flora of the estuarine region will be reintroduced, including mangroves and their companion plants such as Kodikkal, Umiri, Pinnari, Kattisavukku. Once mangroves are established, they attract a whole host of creatures which find a home in this protective environment. Scavenging fiddler crabs, and horn shells recycle organic matter. The mudskipper, oysters, hermit crabs and green mussels will be seen again. As the creek and the mudflats heal themselves, a host of birds will revisit the Adyar wetlands, including pelicans and the white-bellied sea eagle. Once the vegetation is established, the intricate web of forest creatures will weave its natural magic. The clue to the success of the Adyar Eco-Restoration Project is its interaction with people, helping them understand and value the river, creek and estuary. To foster awareness and action on environmental and social issues affecting urban areas, people will be invited to participate in the restoration process. Many contact areas have been designed in the master plan. Indigenous species, medicinal, Navagraha and butterfly gardens will invite people to learn and interact with nature. The geology and the history of the Adyar River will be explained. Freshwater fish ponds will showcase the coastal indigenous aquaculture. A small organic farm will demonstrate the indigenous food crops, including grains of Tamil Nadu. Observation trails along the edges of the estuary and viewing decks will allow people to experience the beauty of the wetlands. a wetland education center will be located in an existing building. Programs for school children and other park visitors will enable people to learn about the environment, in the environment, for the environment. Information stone panels will be placed at various points in the park. The Green Centre is planned as an eco-friendly building placed outside the 58-acre site. It will orient visitors to the meaning of the park. Solar power will be practically demonstrated. Water requirements for the centre and the Poonga will be met by treating raw sewage from the adjacent sewage pumping station. Rainwater harvesting, grey water recycling and reverse osmosis water treatment will be built into the design of the building. In order to engage the community in a dialogue about the environment, exhibition spaces and a library are planned in the Green Center. This resource center will conduct a sustainable schools program for schools. Also, an outreach education program will encourage school children to use the Poonga as their living laboratory for discovery and learning. The Adyar Poonga will be a lifelong learning in ecology, sustainability and environmental education for the city of Chennai. It will change attitudes and provide inspiration to park visitors and the local community to restore and preserve the Adyar Creek ecosystem.